electrolytic capacitors are indispensable components in electronic circuit. Although compared to other components, they can deteriorate over time. Sometimes they can be the cause of circuit malfunctions, a topic we have seen in my previous two videos on capacitor and how to measure ESR. Another problem that afflicts the capacitors is related to their deterioration when they are stored. In fact, they can dry out and begin to leak. Here we are not talking about leakage of the electrolyte, but the passage of direct current through the capacitor, current that the healthy capacitor should block. Due to their construction nature, which we'll not investigate in this video, electrolytic capacitors can maintain their characteristic only if constantly subject to a direct current. If instead they are stored, the absence of polarization causes the electrolyte to dissolve the insulating layer between the plates. This explanation is very simplified, but in short, by applying a direct current and therefore polarizing a capacitor stored for a long time, the electrolyte has the ability to regenerate the insulating layer between the two plates and thus regenerate the capacitor, which can return to work. If you also have used or stored stock of capacitor purchased from a long time, or you want to use a new old stock capacitor to restore an old device without inserting two modern components, it may be necessary to check if the capacitor still has its blocking capabilities for direct current, or it has a loss and less direct current flow. The instrument that I show you today is used to measure the leakage current of a capacitor. As you can see, it consists of an indicator, in this case an analog indicator, but you can also use your tester. The other parts of the instrument are this rotary switch that selects the mode of operation, and this is the test switch to perform the test after the capacitor is charged. The instrument is equipped with two output sockets to which the capacitor to be tested can be connected respecting the polarity. The indicator, which will show the capacitor leakage current, this is a 50 microamp meter by a rotary switch that allows you to select three modes: capacitor discharge, battery power supply, external power supply. A test button is used to perform the test. Quindi, starting from the discharge position, we connect the leads of the capacitor to be tested. Turn the switch to the charging position. As you can see, a red LED turn on, showing that we are powering the circuit from the battery. And the meter show the charge of the capacitor. If you turn the switch on the external position, a red LED will glow, showing that the external power supply is used to power the circuit. This lets us power the circuit with greater voltage to test the capacitor. The maximum voltage you can use with this instrument is 30 volts, used obviously with the external power supply facility. As in the battery position, when you turn the switch to external position, the capacitor is charged. For large capacity capacitors, the charging time can be a few seconds long. In any case, at some point, the current flowing through the capacitor must stop when it has been charged, and the current fall to zero. Now that the capacitor has been charged, there should be no more passage of current. If we press the test button, the pointer should remain at zero. By pressing the test button, we are changing the range of the instrument to 50 microamps full-scale deflection to be able to appreciate currents of few tens of microamps. As you can see, this capacitor stays to zero. even if I press the button, it stays to zero. So this capacitor is not leaky. If the capacitor is leaking, it could be true of regenerating it by passing a direct current of 0.5 1mA for a certain time. This will regenerate the insulating layer between the plates and the capacitor could stop leaking. If we leave the capacitor connected to the instrument, we are in fact giving a constant current to the capacitor, so we are performing some regenerating action. Now I will show you a very old leaky capacitor and how the instruments identify the leakage current. As before, we connect the capacitor respecting polarity. We will test this capacitor in the battery position. The capacitor charge and then current go to zero. If we press the test button, you see about 5 microamps current, maybe less, but this is a leakage current. Check this other capacitor. In a few moments, I will show you the circuit of this device, and if you don't want to use an analog meter like me, you can use your tester. And we have to say, a digital multimeter, it's a very precise measure of the leakage. I saw this circuit somewhere many years ago, but I can't remember where. The circuit is incredibly simple. It is made from a constant current generator capable of supplying 1mA, a test button that deactivates the shunt for the instrument, and if you use your tester as an instrument and not an analog instrument like mine, you can omit all this part. There is a rotary switch here to select from two different power sources, from battery. It could be different from a 9-volt battery, it's all up to you, and from an external power. Looking at the circuit, we can see that the rotary switch here have three sections, all for four possible positions. In the position 1, as you can see, we will start the explanation from the section that activate the power source. In the first position of the rotary switch, as you can see, the section that manages the power of the circuit gives no power, is disconnected. The second section that manages the LEDs of the circuit is disconnected, and only the first section is connected. This is the discharger. You can put your capacitor under test here, device under test, and you start with a switch in the position 1, you put your capacitor. If the capacitor is charged for any reason, it will be discharged through this path. I have inserted a 47 ohm resistor, as you can see, and the discharge of the capacitor takes place. Moving the switch in the second position, as you can see, the first section of the rotary switch is disconnected. The power section of the rotary switch connects the source from the battery, and the second section of the rotary switch activates the green LED. Look at the path of the current. The 9-volt battery connected goes, and through the 1.5K resistor goes to the green LED, indicating that we are using the battery source. When the voltage is applied, here the constant current generator, wherever voltage you apply here, even greater than 9 volt, you have a constant current flowing to this resistor here. This 1mA current goes here, charge the capacitor. You can see the meter moving in my version, and even your tested, you can see the meter goes to 1mA. This is the reason for the shunt. because if you use a 50 microamps meter here, you need a shunt to pass 1 milliamp of current through the meter. So the capacitor will be loaded at voltage about 4 volt less of the power voltage. When the capacitor is charged, you can see the current in the meter goes to zero. If you have an analog meter like me, deactivate the shunt, so the range of the meter return to 50 microamps, you can measure the leakage current. For an ideal capacitor, when this is charged, no direct current should be flow through the capacitor. Any current is flowing through the capacitor is a leakage current. Talking about the external power that I set to a maximum of 30 volts, you can change the value of the components to use higher voltage if you want. If you put the switch in the fourth position, the external power supply will be connected. You connect here your bench power supply at the voltage that you want, and the path of the current is the same. We go to the top here of the circuit. Through the 1.5k ohm resistor, we go to the fourth position of the second section, and the red LED will be on. That indicates that we are using an external power supply. The functioning of the constant current generator is equal. In any case, 1 milliamp is flowing through the diode D2, but the capacitor connected here will be charged to a voltage that is 4 volt minus the external voltage. The same functioning of before apply here. You can measure the leakage current after the capacitor have charged.